Level 4. Still stuff I've played through before. Sigh. Now this we can't go through. I'll show you guys. Because it's entertaining, actually.
Ah!
It looked like he was actually trying to, you know, stop the leak with his arm. So we're gonna go in here first. Light.
Air filtration unit check, day 18th of October 95, 1611, checked by PJT. Main filtration unit running okay, cleaned out and replaced filters. Check back up just to be sure. Readings are a bit high, but Frank says no need to replace at the moment. Probably just as well. I'm concerned about our stock level of filters for the main unit. We're chewing through them a lot faster than spec says, due to higher outdoor rad than expected. Frank says he'll have a word with Bishop about stocks and sorting out the backup longer term. PJ.
So they're running out of everything. Food and filters. I mean, now food is no longer an issue because there's only one person to eat it. Backing out. Computer. Critical. Fault detected. Main air filtration system status active. Filter effectiveness 71%. Filter broken or obstructed. Replace filter immediately. Disconnect pressure at main valve before continuing. Backup. Air filtration system status offline. Filter effectiveness 0%. There is either effectively or non-existent completely no backup air filtration system, as we're going to see or hear about in a moment. It's an Amstrad, look at that. Only one drawer. That we can open anyway. Accident book, and we can take that. Got another friend.
The engineer.
Fixes all the problems down in the scary levels. So we're gonna get a nice collection now.
Accident report, date 12th of August 92, 1910, filed by F. Hurley.
Frank Hurley?
Ran scheduled test of backup filtration unit. Rad levels way too high on output. Over 500 rem, red lights across the board. Thought it was a duff filter, tried a new one, same.
Sacrificed a Geiger, stuck it on a rod and ran it round inside the casing.
Different voice.
We've got contaminated dust clogging the lower X duct.
Back to your voice.
God knows how it got in. Might be a hairline, or maybe the filter just couldn't cope with the levels being so much higher than we expected. This is really, really bad. Without taking this apart, cleaning, resealing, and decontaminating the whole thing, it's useless. We have no backup air filtration system.
Yep.
But I can't see how we can do it. We don't have a clean space to do this in. Bishop just shrugs pretty much. Keep it quiet, Frank. You'll only worry people. Oh, for fuck's sake. What else isn't he telling us?
He's been keeping a lot of secrets from you guys. And it can't always be in your best interest. I mean, you gotta know stuff. If more people know things, and maybe trust them not to panic, at least some of them, you might be able to come up with a solution. But no. So yeah, he's saying there is no backup air filtration system. This is it. Alright, so it's all we can look at in here. So we can go here. Turn this thing off. Main pressure valve. Nice and quiet. Now we want to go there where you saw a flash just for a second. Now that the steam isn't blowing out, we can go there. And this we can't even do anything with yet. This is the thing I was trying to look at over and over again. It kept showing me a blank screen. These are the air filters that we need. Well, I'm missing something though. I'm supposed to walk forward or something? You know, I think I had more trouble... I mean, I think I had less trouble finding it... Yeah, with the screen completely black. It shows up better with a black screen. This must be the filters, and the radiation's coming out because it's no longer filtering out radiation. This is what I couldn't figure out what we were doing here. I guess that one's fine. How about this one? Yep, that one's pretty messed up.
I think I could use these to fix the unit. I need to get rid of this damaged filter first. The spare filters.
I guess we throw it in here, right? Because this is a contamination proof or something. Because the filters are radiated.
I think I could use these to fix the unit.
You sure can. Looks like you might have just one more. What if I hit this? Nothing. Just wanted to see if it would say something.
I've already done that.
Yeah. We've already done that, and we're just gonna go here. Now, I don't want to give anything away, but something happens when he turns the valve on, and I'm not sure what it is. I have an idea, but the thing was blacked out for like 2-3 minutes straight. I couldn't see what happened to him. He doesn't die. But yeah, I'm interested to see just what the hell happened when we turn this thing back on. Was it... Oh. Did you trip on the ladder or something? It looks a little rickety. Yeah, looks like that's it. Didn't have a problem the first time. Oh boy. He hasn't even turned it on yet. Just imagine me looking at a black screen at this point, not knowing what the hell is going on. I'm moving all around. Am I supposed to click on something? Screen completely black, just hearing this. Him breathing and that, whatever, that alarm sound. You know what the hell is going on.
Who's coming?
Did he turn the thing on? Does he turn the thing on? This whole thing was black too for me. It's horrible. So it is more flashbacks. I don't know if he managed to turn it back on, or he just got up and ran up here. He never did switch on the main valve. At least I'm assuming he didn't, because we didn't see him do it. Guess that's giving him the strength to climb. Really got hurt. Level 2. Look up the stairs and you can go to the med bay. Get the strength. There you go. Sounds painful. This whole thing was still black for me. Black screen. Ew. I could have done without seeing that. The black screen saved me there, but not now. Now this part I think I saw. So that's glass in his arm? Well, that's his bone. He broke his arm. You know, I thought it was glass the first time. I mean, it looks clear, not... Not sure why he's doing that. Is he trying to stop himself from hyperventilating or something? That's my guess. This part I could see. That looks like glass! I guess it is his bone. Because you see what happens. Oh, ow.
She can't have had her white cell count so low yesterday, and then so high. Understand it. And she's no better.
Vomiting, bleeding, diarrhea, liver failure, it's got to be.
It can't be radiation sickness. Look, these...
Of course it can. This place probably leaks like a sieve. It was built by the lowest bidder.
Vault-Tec.
No one thought there'd be a real war. I know Bishop said that we'll be safe here, but honestly, George, do you believe him? I'm sorry.
No, don't worry. We've all been under a lot of pressure. Margaret, where's the Lindane ointment?
I think that top left.
You and Evelyn had it for Mrs. Harrison.
Yes, but there were two unopened bottles there on Monday. We have to keep on top of the stock. We can't have...
What is it?
You know what?
Nothing. It doesn't matter.
Oh. So was someone poisoning somebody with lindane ointment, putting it in the food? It's a little easier to piece things together when you actually have screens. I should stop complaining now, guys. Yeah, and it's... gotta open it too. This is artichoke. Why is that artichoke? Oh, there's a lindane ointment. You know, I should look at this. For topical use only, may cause serious side effects. Lindane, okay. Okay, read it. Okay, good. I missed this whole thing here. Lindane, gamma hexachlorocyclohexane. Okay, we'll just call it lindane, is approved for topical treatment of lice and scabies, really, in patients who have either failed to respond to adequate doses or intolerant of other approved therapies. Do not apply this medication to the face, eyes, nose, or mouth. Flush with water if you get medication in any of these areas. Seek medical attention if lindane topical is ingested or if irritation is persistent. Do not apply lindane topical to open cuts or wounds. Doing so could cause too much medication to be absorbed by the body, which can be very dangerous. Store lindane topical at room temperature away from moisture and heat. This was given to people. This was given to Vera, wasn't it? I have an ability to look at something else here. Or was it just that? I thought I could also look at this. Never mind. Alright, so here, and then we got here. This is what he needs. Yeah, he's setting it. He's making, keeping it straight. Pretty smart. I would have no idea what to do. Luckily, I don't have to drag my mouse around. He does all the work. Oh, got it up now. We're wrapping it. Well, maybe if something like this happens to me and I have to set my own arm, I can remember this scene. I can't imagine. I mean, you have a very good high chance of passing out. Poor guy. He's pretty miserable. Well, his mama told him. Don't leave your room and you'll be safe. Look what happened. Radiation warning. He never turned back on. That's the problem. Warning. Status offline. 0% effectiveness. Radiation levels rising. Evacuate bunker immediately. I'm not sure. He looks like he saw something there, doesn't he? Like he saw someone coming, or something coming. Radiation, radiation. So we're almost to the part where I left off. And after that I'll be blind. But you do have a little bit more to go. So we have the map. He just has to stick to the areas that are not irradiated. Oh, his name's John.
Don't we know we're dead?
Not Sam.
I was just exploring.
Oh, John.
I want that door sealed shut immediately.
I wonder who John's father is.
For Christ's sake, Margaret. Keep your little shit in his quarters before he explores the wrong place and gets us all killed.
Seal that door immediately.
Damn. Okay. So back this way. Got something down here.
PJ, please put the oxy tanks back in the cupboard and lock it when you're done with the weld. Don't need Bishop on my back about this as well. Be sparing with fuel. We'll need to cut ourselves out again someday, God willing. This is overkill and a waste of oxy, but we'll keep him happy. Well, if happy is something he's capable of. Frank.
Or we'll keep him less grouchy. Keep him happy, crossed out, less grouchy. That does not even fit that. Funky colors. Was he starting to like pass out from the exertion or something? So the only thing else we can explore is going this way. And we come upon that flashback we saw again. Get to see a little bit more of it this time. Glass from when the flashback happened.
Quickly.
Now I guess were they trying to escape or just to get away from?
Well done. Well done, love. We're safe now. Won't be long now, I promise.
Were they just trying to get away from him? I mean, even if you broke that, oh, you guess you could reach your arm through and then pull that. Is that the point of view of someone walking past those, you know? Emergency access. Still not up to blind territory.
And we've finally been able to take some proper readings from the RA-14 sensors. They show we have a range of 700 to 1,000 rads for anyone exposed to the atmosphere.
What does that mean?
Well, anything over 200 rads can be fatal.
No. How long before it's safe to go back up?
Our best guess, 20 to 30 years.
That's
a long time.
Sam, can we last that long? Do we have enough food?
Yes, it'll be all right.
If there's only one person,
yeah. We have to ration a little, but it'll be all right.
Actually, two people could have lasted. Because he made it to 30. How old is he there? 10?
Everything's going to be fine.
So it's quite some time before they even delivered this news. Because the bomb dropped when he was born. And he's like, what, 10, 12 there or something like that? So here we can look at the map here. We're here.
The escape hatch must be in here somewhere.
We need to go down there. Does he? I think he says something else.
The fire escape. It leads down to the other blast doors.
Right. Good to know. So here we've got that same map again. Heathrow Airport, London, 7,000 dead. Waltham Forest, 1567 confirmed dead. And Greenwich awaiting update. I think they're all different. We only got three this time. Alright, so what else can we look at?
Find another way out of here.
Yeah, his vision keeps blurring like that.
Churchill.
He likes smoking cigars, but saved us in a war. Only missing three. I almost missed him too. Oh wait.
A hatch.
There you go. You gotta move that. Somehow. With a broken arm. This whole thing was black, I couldn't see it, but I figured out what he was doing. Don't pass out, man. You can do it. Yeah, it's gotta hurt. It looks like it's bleeding more now. Escape to freedom. You should probably die from radiation once you go outside anyway. I'm clicking, guy. You can do it. I'm clicking it. It doesn't even swing up. The whole thing just comes off. Yeah, it's gotta be tough with a... Now this is where I got up to. A little bit of this. I could tell he was going down a rungged ladder. But it was black. Now I can see it, which is great. I think that's a fail state right there. Okay, proceeding blind from here on out. I have not been this far. Just trying to be ready in case I need to catch him again. I still keep wondering if someone else is in here with him. But living for all this time, hiding from him? I mean, I know the computer couldn't know that somebody was there. It can't sense life forms, I'm pretty sure, nothing like that. What's this?
Well, I'm calling it. 12th of November, 1992. Carol and I have been scanning all the bands for 3 days now, just in case. But there's nothing. The last contact we had with anybody was 17th of October. CN1 in Bedfordshire. From what I could work out, they were fighting over food. Have I heard anything more? So that's it. We're done. There's no one else out there. Or if there is, they've got no idea we're here. 12th of November, 1992. The day this became our tomb. Christ, I need a drink.
I think you need a few drinks. So, was that a light switch? Oh, I gotta release it? Oh, wait a second. I thought that switch would, like, open the door or something, but... Oh, I lost it. I went outside the circle. I don't want to hit that. Level 5. The dreaded level 5.